out?
I think it's, again, it is difficult to say whether it's being done properly in schools or not, and whether that's the reason that women don't do it.
So, but
I think
the pupils there seem to be enjoying their physics lessons. Let's talk to two more women who enjoy physics. Professor Helen Gleeson teaches physics, and Helen Carrington is studying physics A level. Very good morning to you. Helen Carrington, are you at an all girls school?
Yes, I'm at Willington Girls School.
Right, so that sounds like it is an advantage because there's no boys there. Do you think that that's part of the reason that there isn't this divide at your school?
I think so, because you're not actually worried about percentage of boys to girls, it's 100% girls, and it doesn't even cross your mind. I mean, it hadn't really occurred to me that much.
So when you decided to do physics at A level, and so you're taking the exams this year?
This year, yeah.
Was the issue about whether boys do it more in your head at all, or were you just doing the thing you're good at?
No, it didn't actually occur to me, probably because I'm in a little bubble, but I was just doing what I loved.
Mm. And Professor Helen Gleeson, then, you teach physics at Manchester University.
Yeah.
Do you feel sad about the fact there aren't enough young women coming through to do it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we have about 20% of our class is female. And, you know, the statistics that are out about the continued lack of women taking up even A-level physics, I think is very worrying. It limits their opportunities for future careers, but also from the point of view of the country, it's not a good thing to not be taking full advantage of people who could contribute to science and engineering, technology, across the board. So I don't think it's a good thing for anybody.
Yeah, so it's 2 out of 10 at the level you're teaching at, 2 out of 10. Where do you think the problem kicks in first? I mean, does it go way back? Is it right back to sort of prejudices that, you know, boys are more towards science? And is that where it starts?
I think if there was an easy answer to that, we might have solved it. But yes, absolutely, I think it does go way back. You know, people, I think parents, teachers, and many adults view physics, potentially exclusively physics, as being very, very much something for boys and something that boys do and men do. And so maybe it's just subtle things like lack of encouragement early on, lack of expectation. You know, that's not what girls do.
I suppose what you need is a role model as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know where you look. Maybe you look in pure science itself, or maybe you look on television to look at who does science on TV. They're men, aren't they?
Yeah, it's true. But there is the whole Brian Cox effect, that lots more people are taking up physics, but you don't see a lot of female physicists who are putting out the message that you can do it, even if you're a girl.
When did you start getting interested in science?
Science as a general subject must have been about 7 or 8. I went on a science course in the summer. It's called SciTech, and I absolutely loved it. But then you love science, but you don't know. Do you love physics, chemistry? And you don't quite get that until you get all three subjects being taught separately, and then it suddenly clicks that that's the one you like.
Hooking them young is key, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, I think enthusing people, making them see how widely applicable physics is, that it's not just a subject that's a blue sky subject, but actually it has a huge impact on all of our lives every day.
It is one of those things that is so key, isn't it? Because I remember going back to when I was taught science, it was like there was science and then there's life, you know, like that, as if they were completely different things. And do you think that is still not being done correctly within schools? This is the implication of some of this report.
I think it's, again, it is difficult to say whether it's being done properly in schools or not, and whether that's the reason that women don't do it. But I think that there is certainly an effect whereby if people don't see, if they see a subject as very much blue sky, it's not applicable, it's very technical, then maybe they just don't really see where the careers will lead to, what sort of thing you can go on and do.
Can I just ask Helen lastly, I mean, the dream job for you in science in the future is what? Where will you go with your science?
Well, for me personally, I would really love to become a teacher, because some physics teacher. I've had some brilliant physics teachers, and is one of the main reasons that I would really love to do that.
Physics teachers?
Actually, yeah. Out of the three physics teachers at my school, 2 of them are female.
Good to see you both here this morning. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We're going to